to host your home games. Therefore,
that would be at Tabatswana.
Tabatswana. We'll be okay. Right there at Tabatswana. We will be playing our LFA games. So the LFA adopted us and they said that no, we will give you the ground. So we're going back there for our regional games.
So training, let train our union buildings. What are
you know, it was tough because now with the city, everything we must pay for. And sometimes we've been knocking doors. We came here, I think last January, we spoke to people that were knocking doors in different schools, we're knocking doors in different institutions. But when we get there, no one is opening a door for us. Maybe it was because people looked down upon us. They're like, no, this is just an LFA team that is being run by people at Union Building. Not knowing that what we're capable of, but I believe that with the status that we are holding now, so many doors will open.
So I'm also assuming, as I come back to you, Chem, I'm also assuming that then your feeder area is the CBD, sort of, your Arcadia, Trials and whatnot. These are the areas you're looking at. Because I would imagine a team that is called Mamelodi, you would imagine their feeder area, team that plays for Paley and so on and so forth. But with you being in the CBD, if one could, that is your feeder area. That's where you rely to get your players from.
Yes, yes. We actually rely more especially on the institutions.
Okay.
Like TUT, University of Pretoria, and other colleges around Pretoria, because that's where you get students. And that's where you get some
those
of
those who did not succeed in the trials.
not rejections.
No, but yeah. It's not necessarily that those who don't succeed in trials are bad players per se. And I suppose sometimes for them it's a blessing in disguise in that you are not selected for either Techies or TUT, and then you get to find a team like Zwashu where you then are able to express yourself.
Yeah. If I can tell you, JK, we when we started this team, we had a player who have got a very fascinating story. The one here was a player of the season.
Yeah.
Lafo was unfortunate in his career. He played for Venda Football Academy.
Okay.
Which is playing on the NFD now.
Sure.
And then things didn't go well. You know football. Sometimes it will hurt you. And then he decided to say, let me come to Pretoria, play on the LFA. He promised me that, Chairman, I'm going to deliver promotion to you. I'm going to gain the status. And I was like, hey, many people say that. He said, I'm going to deliver it. Guess what? Today, as we sit here, we have got the SAB status.
Sure.
Through his teammates and the coach as well. So, JK, you mentioned about our ambitions.
Sure.
As to what is the vision. Look at Chipampangesi. Just an example. He started from Castle. ABC, which was Vodacom then.
Get worried for the coach.
Vodacom,
sure.
NFD,
sure.
Then PSL. He's surviving now.
Yeah.
How many seasons now? More than 8. So it's possible. For us is to say Black Child is possible. You can make it. So I believe with the assistance of our sponsors as well and the people who are supporting us, we're going to make it.
And this was going to be my last question, Chair, before we close the conversation. Speaking of sponsors, we last week got news that Dondol FC have sold their status because they are saying, we've tried all we could, we can't anymore. Let's sell the status and focus on the youth teams because we tried promotion, we played in the net bank, and surviving and getting sponsors when you are playing, I mean, you were playing for LFA. It's only now that you are coming into the region.
Yes.
How are things looking at that? Are there people that believe in your vision and say, Emon, take this? Or are we still looking at a situation where Coach Unaldi Bolote finds it and his whole team is made of 23 players?
It's not easy. Mm. But when you mention the Dondol story, it's very painful because we are very close with the chairman of Dondol.
Yeah.
I remember when we were doing the preparation for the playoffs, he gave us some about 10 soccer balls to say, guys, go and prepare, you're gonna make it. When I saw the news that he sold the status because of some financial issues, it was very painful. But with us, we've been fortunate. We had some guys who believed in us and who believed in the vision.
Mm-hmm.
Just to mention a few, there's this lady called Nancy. She ran a restaurant in Centurion R55. JK, that lady, she has been an angel to us. Our players, they go there, they have got meals there. If they are camping, because some of the times we have to camp because we need to prepare.
Mm.
So she will bring food to say, hey, this place must eat. So those are the assistance that we are getting.
Sure.
So, but it's not easy to get sponsors But we are grateful for those ones who are coming. Akwele as well, they were giving us about 300 bottles every month for water. So, yeah, some they are coming, but we are still calling for sponsors and business people. Please believe in the vision. Let's give African child hope. That's what we are for.
As long as you don't sell those bottle of waters to the players, coach, like one chairperson in the chairman in the NFD. JJ, yeah. Do you have any questions before?
There's a congratulations for Zwashu and all the best through from Maxwell.
Yeah, there's congratulations. Look, I cannot let go of you, Chair, and I think Coach mentioned the LFA, the welfare, and we've had the leadership of welfare that they as well as the Secretary General, and I forget his name,
LP.
And I think, you know, sometimes it's one thing to speak to people on radio about what they are doing until a testimony comes and say this is what's happening. And I think if they are listening to us, we'd like to congratulate welfare as well, because obviously you were competing with the other LFAs and you came through. But from us at Tswan FM, we'd like to wish you well as well. In the season. When is the season starting, Coach?
Surely early September.
Early September, you're starting with the season.
We're starting with the net bank now.
Oh, okay.
End of August. Yeah.
No, don't meet Kaiser Chiefs. I'm a Kaiser Chiefs support, and I'm very scared of these big small teams. Everyone thinks they can beat us, but Chef Navi is there. But guys, thank you so much for your time. Also, soon we hope we'll speak to Lafour. Due to time, we can't bring him on today, but maybe before the season starts or somewhere during the season, we'll have him on. Thank you so much for your time this evening. We really, really appreciate it and look forward to celebrating with you.